Welcome back, cartography fans. Let's say that later in this series, when we walk up North Table Mountain, you don't want to take the road, and you'd prefer to hike straight up by the water tank. What would be the steepness of the slope you would be climbing? Slope is basically the rise over the run, the elevation change over the horizontal distance change. To go from this point to this point in a straight line, and we'll try to cover this area of consistent slope for this example, we start at 6,060 feet and end up at 6,250 feet for a 190-foot elevation climb. We went across a horizontal distance of, we measure here and compare on our bar chart to see it was around 920 feet. So 190 feet divided by 920 feet is 0.21. And that's a unitless number because you did feet divided by feet. It's a unitless number, which is zero when you're on a flat surface. It's infinite when you're vertical. And its value is one when you're at a 45 degree angle. If we multiply it by 100, we get the percent gradient. So this 0.21 slope is a 21% gradient. Because we're under a slope of 1, we must be under a 45 degree angle. But what angle are we? Time to pull out your rusty trigonometry skills and recall that we are looking at a right triangle, with the elevation being the opposite to this angle, and the run being the adjacent. You walked up the hypotenuse, weirdo. In trig, the opposite and adjacent sides can be used to find the angle thusly. Tangent equals the opposite over the adjacent. So if the tangent of the angle is equal to what we just calculated, opposite divided by adjacent, we just use inverse tangent on this value to get the angle back, and you see that you walked up an almost 12 degree slope angle. Okay, now you know you hiked up a 12 degree slope over a 920 foot horizontal distance, but in what direction? To get a bearing on a map, we use a protractor of some kind. You may also need a ruler to extend your line, but it's as easy as lining up the protractor with the grid lines of the map and extending your line through its origin point and read off the other end to get the angle. We can report any direction as bearings, which look as follows, just giving the angle direction off the cardinal points of the compass. In this series, I will try to be consistent, and this is what we do all through our undergraduate program here at the Colorado School of Mines. We'll use the azimuth readings, which start at 0 degrees for true north, 90 degrees for east, 180 degrees for south, and 270 for west. And if you feel uncomfortable about how to use a compass, don't worry. That's our next episode.